Hi, this is Jan here from filmdev.com. Today I want to show you how you can use the track data you get from a RotoScope tool in After Effects to create a keyframed mask for other layers. Okay, so I've created the scene in After Effects with my son battling some TIE fighters, and I've used the Saber plugin from Video Copilot to create the Saber effect. And I've also gone ahead and rotoed the body of and the head of my son so I could get the TIE fighters to be behind him. But as you can see, we still have this problem with the saber. The saber needs to be in front of him, and now right now it's covering his head as he swings the saber in front of him. So we need to create a mask. Now I could go in and manual track a mask around his body, but that would just take too much time, and that's a much quicker way to do this. You simply go to the roto track you already created, which has all the data you need, and then you go to layer, auto trace, and this pops up. You can tweak these different parameters, but I find that for this kind of work, you already, if you've done the roto properly, you have already created some good data. So I usually just leave it as is. Maybe I change the tolerance to maybe between 1 or 5, but usually it works with just 1 because of the mask you've already created with the RotoScope tool. So I press OK, and then you just leave the computer to think a bit, and then you will see in a moment, yep, there it is. A new track up here has been created, which contains a keyframed mask data. And you can simply copy paste this data to whatever track you need. So in this case, I want to paste it to the saber. So I'll just make sure I select all of the data here. Press Ctrl C and make sure you have the playhead right at the beginning. So data will be pasted in the right place. So I go to the saber layer and I press Ctrl V to paste it. Okay, so right now I'll just remove this layer so we can't see it anymore, and you can see we still have a problem with the lightsaber up here. Okay, that is because you need to go to the saber and change the mask to subtract instead, and there you go, a keyframed mask from created from the RotoScope selection you've already made. So quick and dirty trick, and if you like this video, give it a thumbs up. You can see this in more detail on my blog. I'll post a link in the description where I've broken it down into more steps, and where you can also see how to use the RotoScope tool if you're unfamiliar with this. So that's it for now. Bye.